Smithy, as well as half of Ruzy in Reckless after victorious Team Ice here in tandem mode. I'm going to go to you two first here. What was the main strategy for the team in terms of picking champions? Was it looking for things that, you know, were going to depend more on, you know, mechanics or less mechanics? What kind of skill shots were you guys looking to hit? Why did you land on Nautilus of all things?
They banned our Alistar. We were going to carry the whole game with Alistar, but they banned it, so we had to, like, adapt in between.
All right, well, you landed on a hooking champion, and you were up against Madlife, or Celeblife, I should say, the, you know, half of a hook master over there. So was there any kind of nerves walking into that lane up against Madlife, knowing that you're both playing hook champions?
I mean, not really, because when the lane started and we saw how they were playing and how they were hooking backwards, we were really relaxed that it was going to be an easy win for us.
There were plenty of mechanical errors and mishaps that made for the game to be really fun. But now I want to talk about communication, because I've got both kind of halves of the bot lane here. Was there much communication between the actual tandems, or you spent most of the time trying to communicate with Uzi just about what you're going to do with your own champion?
I think between me and Uzi, it was quite straightforward. I mean, it's not so much dependent on what I do on the keyboard when you're playing Twitch. But I think as a team, we were actually communicating quite well. We were even setting up dives at times, even though it's a bit limited because everyone doesn't speak that well in English. But we had some cool plans going into the game and during the game, so it was really fun to play together with these guys.
Now, how does this game mode, I mean, obviously there's a lot of differences between this and a normal game of League of Legends, but we saw a 10K gold lead and still fights are going both ways. So, you know, how do you navigate knowing that you have a gold lead, but the fact that really so much of it is going to be about execution and not the number of items that you have?
Well, it just becomes a lot like solo queue because we can't really like make super deep plans. So everyone is just like pinging around, like saying like Baron, Baron, dive, dive. So it's like very straightforward and it obviously goes wrong a lot of times.
Absolutely. All right. Well, that, of course, grabs you guys 50 points, which brings the point totals a little bit closer. Xpeke, Team Ice has the lead and more players, yourself included, in the 1v1s, which are coming up next. So now you got to kind of reorient yourself from this fun mode to a little bit more serious time. What are you thinking moving on to those 1v1s, and can you bring home the victory for Team Ice?
I think I still got a few champions that I haven't played yet, and I think I can make it to the semis or finals even. So let's go for it.
All right, that's what I like to hear. Those 1v1s are going to be coming up soon, but for now, we're going to throw it up to the desk to try and make sense of all that craziness that just happened.
Craziness in tandem mode. What about your hair? The hair gauntlet has been thrown down. He's what?
He's one.
Like, and that's, you're the man definitely to crown him.
So. Yeah, I mean, he was congratulating me. And he was just like, oh, you pushed my boundaries, and then he just brings us out on the final day.
Absolutely fantastic. Well, let's